Namaste everyone, welcome to the class. Now in this lecture we are going to see a new chapter, production. Here we are going to define production management and explain the functions of production department. Now production, by word you understand, by production what we mean? By production we means to produce something, right? So a department which is responsible or which is engaged in producing something is your production department. The production implies creation of goods and services with the help of certain processes. In other words, it is concerned with the conversion of raw material into the semi-finished and finished product by applying various processes and procedures. So here we understand what is production means. So production, it is nothing but creation of goods and services. It is concerned with conversion of raw material into semi-finished and finished product. So the raw material we convert in semi-finished and finished product by applying various processes and procedures. Any process involving the transformation of a set of input or resources like materials, manpower, machinery, information and energy into certain other outputs like finished product, components, parts, etc. may be called production. The essence of production is the creation of product either by the conversion of raw material or through the assembling of small parts. So in production what we are doing, we are converting the raw material into some finished product, or we are assembling small unit and creating a new product. The conversion of input into output adds to the value or utility of the product. Now when we convert raw material into some finished product, then that finished product has more value as compared to that raw material. So here what we say, in this process we are adding value. Okay, the value or the utility created by production is the difference between value of input and the value of output. So how much value we have added, so it is the difference between the value of output and value of input. Production function is creative. It involves proper use of inputs so as to convert them into useful products. Production of goods and services is an intricate and complex process. So here the production of goods and services is an intricate and complex process means this is a very very tedious job to convert raw material into finished product. It involves not just the application of tools to materials, but much thought and logic to work. The flow of material has to be regulated at successive work point in the production system. The production function of the business covers all the activities of procurement, allocation, and utilization of resources. In fact, production of goods and services is the focal point of business activities at all the business operations like purchasing, financing, marketing, storing, etc. So, a lot of new words involved. Let us see again. The flow of material. So, what we say, the production function is a creative. Now, here we are creating something. So, production function is a creative. It involves proper use of input so as to convert them into useful product. Here we are properly utilizing inputs and converting them into some useful outputs. Production of goods and services is an intricate and complex process. Now, this is a very complex process. Here to convert raw material into finished product is a complex job, means different activities are involved here. It involves not just the application of tools to the material, but much thought and logic to work. So not only we are using tools, but we are using our logic and thought also, how to convert input into output. The flow of materials has to be regulated at successive work point in the production system. The flow of material, that means how we are utilizing the raw material, is to be regulated, is to be monitored. The production function of the business covers all the activities of procurement. Now, in this production function, It includes different activities like procurement. We have to procure the raw material, then allocation, where to utilize it, and utilization of the resources. In fact, production of the goods and services is the focal point of business. Focal point of the business means a very, very important point of the business. Okay, you cannot do business if you are not doing production. So it is a focal point of business activities, as all the business operations like purchasing, financing, marketing, storing, etc., revolve around the production. Efficient management of production is therefore essential for the achievement of business objectives. The production system of the enterprise should be such that goods and services of proper quality can be produced at a reasonable cost and at the right time. Okay, so let us see again what we are saying. The production system of the enterprise should be such that the goods and services of proper quality can be produced at a reasonable cost and at right time. The goods and services produced must be capable of satisfying the needs and expectations of the customer. No business firm can survive and grow in the modern competitive economy unless it produces the goods and services required by the customers. Efficient management of production is essential to the profitable functioning of every enterprise. So here, for profitable functioning of every enterprise, it is very much essential that production management should be there. Okay, now let us define. We have understood, okay, what is production is all about and how important the production is. Now let us see the formal definition of production management. The basic aim of the production function is to produce the goods required by the customers in an efficient and economical manner. So here, it is not only the production of goods, but it should be produced in efficient and economical manner. Means we should not waste raw material also, and it should be economical. That means it should not be too costly also. If it is too costly, then who will purchase it? It is essential to plan, organize, direct, and control the production system in order to achieve this aim. These activities are collectively known as production management. According to Buffa, production management deals with decision making related to production processes so that the resulting goods or services are produced according to the specifications in the amount and by the schedule demanded and at minimum cost. In accomplishing these objectives, production management is associated with two broad areas of activities: the design and control of production system. Okay, again, production management deals with decision making related to production processes so that the resulting goods or services are produced according to the specifications in the amount and by the schedule demanded and at the minimum cost. In accomplishing these objectives, production management is associated with two broad areas of activities: the design and control of production system. Thus, so definition, it seems little complicated. Okay, the production management involves planning, organizing, and controlling of the production activities. So now the various functions of the production management is to plan, to organize, and to control the production activities of an enterprise so that the objective of efficiency and economy are achieved. Okay, so why we are doing all these activities? So that the product will be economical and efficient one. It refers to the coordination of material, personnel, machinery, money, and other resources to ensure the supply of required goods and services. Under production management, the managerial functions are applied to the design and operation of the production system. Production management is generally considered to be associated with the operations of factories or plants. Now, production management, if you see, they are very much associated with operations of the factories. Means in factories, work is happening and something is producing. This is so because the production function developed largely in the factories. Why? Because this production function is function is happening in factory only. It was the factory system wherein the problem of how to organize and lay out facilities, how to meet schedules and control quality, etc. arose for the first time. But the modern concept of production is wider and it deals with the operational side of an organization. So here in the beginning, the production management is mostly concentrated in the factories only, but in modern concept, it has a wider concept and it deals with the operational side of the organization also. Production function is no longer confined to plants or factories. Service organizations like hotels, bank, hospitals, college, etc. also have the production system. So we can see that there are various other areas where production system is needed, but we are not producing any new product. The basic feature of all the production system are inputs, conversion process and output. So here the basic feature means in all the production system, what we are seeing that there is some input and we have some conversion process. We are using some technique and we are getting final output. In order to denote the broader view of the production, modern writers use the term production and operations management. However, this chapter deals with the production system of industrial enterprises. So here we are going to discuss the production system of industrial enterprise. Now, functions of the production department. So I hope we understand little about what is the production management, okay, and their functions. Now let us understand the functions of production department in detail. The scope of production management is very wide and it covers a wide range of activities from the location of plant to the packing of product. The design and control of production system requires managerial decisions in the following areas. So production department, if we see design of the product, design of the production system, production planning and control, plant building, layout of the plant, selection of the plant and equipment, research and development, manufacturing, quality control. So we have divided the functions of production department in subheads. So first subhead is design of the product. Okay, so when you want some product, so first you have to think about its design, that how it should look like and what it should be. So design of the product. The product of the product to be produced by a firm is decided by its top management. Once the product is decided, the production department prepares its design. Okay, again, the product to be produced by the firm is decided by the top management. Top management decides what to produce. Once the product is decided, the production department prepare its design. So second stage is that production department will decide how it should look like. The top management decided that we will produce car, then how the car should look like. Okay, it is the function of production department. Product design consists of form and function. The form design is concerned with shape, size and appearance of the product, whereas the function design involves the working condition of the product. So here, this stage, that is design of the product, it again divided into form. One is two part, one is form and one is function. Okay, the form design is concerned with shape, size and appearance. So the form function, it concerns about how it should look like. And there is another part which is function. The function part sees that how it will work. So this is design of the product. Now design of the production system. Once you understand that what you have to produce, then you have to see how it is to be produced. That is design of the production system. Production system is the framework within which inputs are converted into outputs. Design or formulation of the production system involves the choice of an appropriate production system. There are basically three types of production system, namely job production, process production and intermittent production. The choice of one of them depend upon the type of product to be manufactured, the scale of the production, etc. So दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट, डिजाइन ऑफ अ प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम. सो प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम इज अ फ्रेमवर्क. फ्रेमवर्क मीन्स इट इज अ टोटल सेटअप. इट इज अ फ्रेमवर्क विद इन विच इनपुट्स आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू आउटपुट. डिजाइन आर फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम इन्वॉल्व्स द चॉइस ऑफ एन अप्रोप्रिएट प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम. सो हियर वी डिसाइड की वॉट अ प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम वी नीड. देर आर बेसिकली थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन सिस्टम, नेमली जॉब प्रोडक्शन, प्रोसेस प्रोडक्शन एंड इंटरमीडिएट प्रोडक्शन. The choice of one of them depends upon the type of product to be manufactured, the scale of production, etc. So there are three different ways of producing. Okay, they have not described it, but there are these three ways of producing any product. Now production planning and control. Once you decide okay, how you have to produce, now you have to control. It involves the determination and a regulation of production process. Once the product and production system are designed and developed, the production department starts producing, starts production planning. So now the next stage is to start the production planning. So they will start thinking that okay, now we understood what we have to produce, how we have to produce. Now let us start to understand how we start. The production planning is concerned with the planning of production activities before actual operation begin. Okay, it lays down the requirement for the material, machinery, manpower, etc., and establishes the exact sequence of operation for each part or assembly. Okay, so we have decided ki we have to make a car. We decided that how we are going to make. Now the next stage is that we will start planning that from where we will get the raw material, from where we will get the manpower, how they are going to work, etc., etc. A time schedule for the start and completion of each and every item is also prepared. Some timeline is also decided ki this activity will take this much time, this activity will take this much time, like that. Thus the production planning involves looking ahead, anticipating bottlenecks in the production and taking steps to remove the hindrances in the smooth flow of the work. So here what we are doing, here we are in advance thinking about all the consequences, okay, all the problems which we are going to face when we actually start the production, and how to remove those bottlenecks, how to remove those hindrances, okay, how to remove those obstacles. Now the production planning is followed by production control. Okay, so here not only we are planning that how we are going to arrange all these things, we are also thinking about how to control different activities. So production control is a function of comparing actual production with the predetermined standard and taking necessary corrective action. Okay, very good point. Now the production control is a function of comparing actual production with the predetermined standard and taking necessary corrective actions. So here what we are doing, here we have decided that key, okay, these activities will take this much time and this is how much production we are going to get. Okay, now when actual working starts, then in that case we have to cross check whether what we have planned we are getting or not. If you are not getting it, then we have to take the corrective actions. Production control involves control actions in the following areas: control of inventories, control of flow of raw material into the plant, control of work in process, control of quality of the product, control of cost of production. So there are different heads which we have to control. Okay, thus production planning and control is required for the efficient and economical operations of the production system. Then selection of the location. The next point is selection of the location. The choice of the place where the factory or the plant is to be located has an important influence on the cost of production. Plant should be located at such a place where the production and distribution cost are the minimum. Okay, very good point. Now where we will set up our production unit, we will set up our production unit at such a place where our total cost of production will be minimum. So sometimes raw materials are very bulky, so we keep our production location production near to the raw material location, and sometime we place it near to the area where we have to sell, like near the market. So all choice depends ki in which case our overall cost of production will be minimum. The location decision is influenced by a number of cost. Example, cost of land and building, transportation cost, labor cost, cost of fuel and power, etc. Several other factors like the scale of operation, production requirement, availability of site, personal preferences, government policies, etc. also exercise an influence on the choice of plant location. Plant building. Next stage is plant building. So here we have seen what are the different factors based on which we are deciding the plant location. So various factors are like cost, labor cost, transportation cost, fuel cost, and several other factors. Okay. Plant and building. The planning of factory building is an important problem of production management. Well-planned building helps to ensure economical and efficient production. Plant building should be designed to fit the requirement of capacity of the plant. It should be adaptable to changes in production process and equipment. Plant building may be single-storied or multi-storied. The choice of plant building depends upon the type of equipment, working condition required, scale of operation, plant location, plant layout, etc. So plant building, the planning of factory building is an important problem of production management. Well-planned building helps to ensure economical and efficient production. So if you design your building in a proper way by understanding various processes involved, then you will get economy. You will get economy means your production will be at the minimum cost. Plant building should be designed to fit the requirement and capacity of the plant. So definitely it should be built according to the requirement. It should be adaptable to the changes in production process and equipment. Now it should be adaptable also means in future if there is some change required, then it should be possible to implement that change in that building. Plant building may be single storied or multi storied. Now it depends on the volume. It could be single-storied or multi-storied. The choice of plant building depends upon the type of equipment, working condition required, and scale of operation. So on all these factors, we decide which kind of plant building we require. Now the next function is layout of plant. Layout of plant. We have decided which kind of building we need, then layout of the plant. Plant layout refers to the arrangement of machineries and facilities in the factory. So now factory is ready. You understand that factory is ready. Now you have to put the machineries there. So the workers will start working. The layout of the plant should be such as to maximize economy and efficiency of operation in the plant. An efficient layout is one that permits the most direct and rapid flow of material through the various stages in the production process. In order to ensure a smooth and uninterrupted flow of materials, it is necessary to minimize the distance, time, and cost involved in material handling. The type of layout to be adopted depends upon the type of production system. There are three types of layout, namely product layout, process layout, and fixed position layout. Under the product layout, machines and equipment are arranged in order in which the product is to be produced, right? So in the first layout, that is product layout, we are going to arrange machines in such a order that they are used in a sequence. In case of process layout, similar machines and equipment are grouped into one department so that each process department one particular type of operation is performed. So the second layout is that we divide areas according to different processes. So for one type of process, okay, means to produce one good, we require different process. So one process we are going to do at one place. So all the machines involved in that process are at one place. So we are doing that process at one position and then shifting it to other location or in that same factory to other place. Okay. Under fixed position layout, the necessary material machines are personnel are brought to one fixed site where the complete job is done. Now, in fixed position layout, what happens? We bring machine and raw material to one position and there we do the job and then again keep them aside like that. So these are the three layout. One is product layout. So in product layout, to produce, what are the different machines required? They are arranged in a sequential order so that the product, I will get the product in a sequence. In process layout, what we do, we keep all the machines related to one process at one place. And in fixed layout, what we do? In fixed layout, we bring material and machine to one fixed position and then do the job. Selection of the plant and equipment. Design, development and installation of the tools and equipment is an important function of production management. Now, design, development and installation of the tool and equipment is an important function of production management. The choice of the plant and equipment depend upon several factors such as scale and quality of output desired, the cost and life of machine, the adaptability of equipment, availability or technological feasibility of the machine, etc. In addition to the choice of equipment, appropriate arrangement must be made for the repair and maintenance of the installed machine. So, selection of plant and equipment means now for a given job, there are different types of machines available in the market. So, which kind of machine is most suitable for me, is most economical to me, that I will arrange and I will use. So, that is selection of plant and machine equipment. Research and development. Continuing arrangement of research and development are required to make improvement in the products. Okay, so it is not like okay, now job is done, but continuously if they need to be in the market, they have to do research and development, means they have to see how they can improve their quality. So to make improvement in the product, process and equipment. Research implies scientific investigations and analysis in order to acquire new knowledge. Applied research is undertaken to evolve proper solution to practical problems through the collection and processing of relevant information. Development succeeds applied research. Development succeeds applied research. It is concerned with the design and fabrication of new products of process and then testing their usefulness, keeping the view of requirement of customers of the plant. Thus, production management is concerned with planning of production input, installation of the required facilities and cooperation of processes of production. Research and development. Okay, now next is manufacturing. Manufacturing here refers to actual process of materials and component parts so as to convert them into finished product. So manufacturing refers to the actual processing of materials and component parts so as to convert them into finished product. So here we will get the finished product. Manufacturing, we are doing manufacturing. Generally, there are several processes which are employed in manufacturing. For example, a cotton textile factory consists of ginning. So for manufacturing something, various processes are involved. Here we are giving one example of cotton textile factory. Here the various the process involved is ginning, spinning, weaving, dyeing and bleaching and pressing sections. In ginning, cotton seeds are separated from raw cotton. Cotton is converted into yarn in spinning section. In weaving section, yarn is converted into cloth. Cloth is given color and finish in dyeing and bleaching section. Several types of machines and equipments are used in the factory for manufacturing of the desired product. Okay, so this is your manufacturing part. And now the last is the quality control. The production department is responsible for ensuring proper quality of goods manufactured in the factory. Right quality is essential for satisfying the customer and making good sales. Several techniques such as inspection, control chart, accurate sampling, ISO certification, total quality management, etc. are employed for this purpose. So this is quality control. Now board of directors. Board of directors, we have managing director, director production, research and development manager, quality assurance manager. Then in director production, we have production planning and control manager, we have work manager, we have repair and maintenance manager. In work manager, we have plant manager 1, plant manager 2, plant manager, different plant managers are there. And then we have different foremen. Foremen are like supervisors. Okay, so again, the whole company, how it is structured. Okay, if we look from production point of view, so there are at top level board of directors, then we have managing directors, then production directors, means other directors we removed. In managing director, we have one department called production and director of production, and under that we have research and development management, we have quality assurance management, and we have production management. In that, production planning and control, work manager, repair and maintenance manager comes. And in that, we have different plant managers. Okay, below them we have different foremen, and below them we have laborers who are working for the organization. So if we summarize, production management refers to the management of manufacturing and related activities in the organization. Production, so this summary part is very, very important. Means if in short you wanted to explain anyone what is the production management, you can write this. So production management refers to the management of manufacturing and related activities in the organization. Production department performs several functions, example designing of the product and the production system, production planning and control, choice of location and the factory building, layout of plant, selection of machineries and equipment, research and development, manufacturing, quality control, etc. Okay, now we have few questions. We have some answers for the questions also. So question is like, define the production, what is production planning, define production control, what is the plant layout. Again, you just go through the topics, means after seeing the questions, again just go through the topic, you will get proper answers for each and every question. Okay, now longer question answer is, what do you understand by the production management? Explain the function of production department in the business firm. Production planning provide the basis of production control, whereas the production control ensures execution of production plant. Comment, we have to comment on this and expand it. The TM, okay, total management, R&D, research and development, PPC, ISO. ISO is what? International certification organization, ISL, YAFR, international system, something. Means we Google it and we will get the answer. PPC, PPC. So research and development is given. PPC, production planning and control. PPC, production planning and control, right? R&D we have done. TQM, total quality management. ISO certification, ISO. So ISO, they have not given full form for ISO. Okay, now here questions, give four functions. So in short, they have given, list the managerial decision involved in production. So all the functions are listed. What is production planning and control? Okay, you can go through it. What is production planning and control? So it involves the determination and regulation of production process. Once the product and the production system are designed and developed, the production department starts production planning. Production planning is concerned with planning of production activities before an actual operations begin. It lays down the requirement of material, machinery, manpower, etc., and establishes the exact sequence of operations for each part of assembly. A time schedule for start and completion of each and every item is also prepared. Thus, production planning involves looking ahead, anticipating bottleneck in production, and taking steps to remove hindrances in the smooth flow of the work. Okay, just go through 2-3 times and you will understand what you have to write for each and every question. Okay, so thank you for being with me in this lecture. I will see you in the next class with a new chapter. Thank you.